There are two Division I coaches in the state of Nebraska who hold a special place in the hearts of fans. Tom Osborne, who led Nebraska to three national championships during his 25 years on the sideline. And Coach Dana Altman, who's taken Creighton to 12 consecutive postseason appearances in his 16 years at the helm. Both men were born and raised in Nebraska, and some might say the similarities don't end there.
He came from a great family that had a great love of sports, and I think all those things kind of contributed to his love of coaching and basketball.
I think his upbringing in a small community with all those different things that we had done when we were growing up, you know, molded him. And, you know, I like to compare him a little bit to Tom Osborne and his demeanor and things like that, because he's small town. He's not out there. He does things the right way, and that's how he grew up, and that's how he is now.
Altman grew up in the small town of Wilber, Nebraska, just 42 miles southwest of Lincoln. Known to many as the Czech capital of Nebraska, some might question the name Altman in a Czech town.
Well, Altman actually is a German name, but I mean, in that time, the country was kind of, they didn't know where the borders were anyway. I mean, but actually, Granddad came from Czechoslovakia.
And that Czech heritage is something that Dana's older brother, Dirk Altman, is keeping alive.
I knew I was going to have to be active in the Czech festival when I went out to college at Kearney State. And I'd say, I'm Dirk Altman, I'm from Wilber. And they go, Wilber, that's where they have Czech days. So I got pretty active in Czech days. And I teach the traditional Czech dance. And I teach them how to polka, a little schottische, and then a little bit of waltz. Yeah, I teach them all to do all those steps.
And you know what? Dana's older brother isn't the only one of the Altman family with those fancy Czech dance moves.
Well, yeah, but he won't admit that.
Well, he was one of the best of the dancers.
Yeah, he was.
He can dance a mean polka.
Dana Altman's dancing skills might remain to be seen, but his coaching, well, that speaks for itself. Early on, Altman entertained another profession far removed from coaching.
Well, when he graduated at Eastern, he went to Albuquerque to take the law test, and he passed it. And became over. Said, Dad, I don't really want to be a lawyer. I still want to prove to myself that I can coach. So he said, that's my first love. I'm going to give it a try. And he got hired at Fairbury, and from there it just took off.
And during Dana's early coaching days at Southeast, Altman's older brother knew he'd made the right choice.
Back in 83, we came back from Scott's Bluff. We played in the regional tournament out there, and I told Dad when we got back, I says, Dad, I don't know when, I don't know how long, but I'll guarantee you one thing. One of these days, Dana's going to be a Division I coach, I'll guarantee you.
While Creighton has remained a good fit for Altman for more than 16 years, there was that moment, you remember, when Altman considered other options.
I'm not going to take a chance how much he knows about the Hulk call. We know what happened. Let's go with it. Woo!
I didn't know about it until I heard it on the TV. I mean, usually he told me ahead of time what he was planning on doing, but that was one time he didn't. And yeah, it was kind of different. When they did the pig suey, I knew he was done.
And the Blue Jay faithful, they breathed a sigh of relief. Yet some of those same fans are questioning their favorite coach after a bumpy start this season. But how do those who know Coach Altman the best think this season will end?
Well, we still got the talent. All we have to do is start playing hard and playing together, and kids listen to him, I think they'll be all right.
He might end up doing one of his best jobs this year. I really personally think when it comes down the end of the year, they'll be playing well, and I have kind of a gut feeling that this might be the year they win that tournament.
One thing is certain. Several TVs in Wilber, Nebraska will be following the action, and two big fans in the arena will be behind Coach Altman, no matter what.